clearly see two segments in the Indian market, transport and the industrial. So this is the overall market breakdown. You see that the overall market is close to 1.9 million ton, which is 74% higher than a decade. So these are the two clear big pieces. 52% market is the transport market, which I deep dive further in my coming slides. And the second big tier, is the industrial segment. So we saw that last year, the transport segment moved up by close to 8%, and the industrial segment moved up by close to 7%. And Valvoline basically competes in the transport segment. Now, deep diving into the transport segment, which is close to 52% of the overall Indian market, the fastest growing segment in the transport category has been the motorcycle segment in India. 4 to 5 years back, this segment contributed close to 7 to 8% was the contribution from the motorcycle category. But of late, last 5 years, this category has grown to 21%. Very, very fast growing category. The heavy duty diesel engine oil, which is the second big tier, which constitutes close to or contributes close to 40%, has been the biggest contributor to the transport segment. The passenger has also seen a steady growth last year, which was close to 9%. So summing it up, within the transport category, the diesel engine oils, which comprises of heavy duty diesel engine oils and the tractor oils, contribute close to 45%, and the motorcycle oils. These two categories contribute close to 66% plus market for the transport segment. In this entire category, transport segment, the foreign players are very actively engaged because of the price points, the marketing innovations, and the influence, and the customer influence. Just taking you through the competitive scenario of the country in the lubricant market, the state-owned still contribute or control 46% plus market share in the country, which eventually went down since the market was deregulated in 1994. It was close to 90%. Foreign brands have increased the market share, which the following slides will talk about. And this is basically due to the innovative marketing base they have brought in the country, the global tie-ups, what they have helped with the leading OEMs in India, and the relationship with the resellers and the influencers have been much, much better as compared to what the earlier decade had seen. BP Castrol, Shell Pennzoil, and Valvoline have been the top three foreign brands in the country. Almost five new entrants, because India has been growing, and every year we see that 4 to 5 new foreign entrants are standing on the doors to hit the market. And as you all know, that Chevron made an exit last year from this market, and it was immediately replaced by their counter Korean affiliates. Now this has been the. Now these are the typical distribution channel for any foreign brand in the country. So there are three main distribution channels for the lubricant business in India. The bazaar trade. The bazaar trade basically comprises of small shops, service garages, and lubricant shops. So whatever is on the streets is classified as bazaar trade. And then the OEM. OEM can be their factory fill their moving products moving through their channel, through the OEM channel, and product moving through their service centers. And then the bulk sales. Bulk sales can be to huge garages or factories or industries. So these first two channels, which is the bazaar and the service center OEM, is driven by the distribution for any foreign brand in the country. And close to what 50% of the market is catered through the distribution-led business, this bazaar trade, which contributes to 48%, is driven by the distribution established by any foreign brand in the country. And again, establishing distribution is really the key to success in India, because the geography is huge. Again, 28 states, different tax regimes. So you have to reach to the customer and the best way to reach to the customer is appointing distributors in each district and area. So typically India is a very different market from basically rest of the India or basically the Western countries. So you have to really understand the consumer behavior and their buying patterns in the country. They are very, very different, and that's the reason that many of the companies which entered while the market was deregulated are still very small. They have still not adapted to the buying behavior and the conditions of the Indian market. You have to really monitor that the sales movement through both the channels. DIFM, which is nearly the 100% of the market, DIY does not exist. So you have to really see that who are the influencers in the business, how does the product movement happen from a distributor or from a company finally to the country. That's what means your supply chain has to be very competent to provide services to the customers on time. That's it from my side. I'm open for questions if you have